I suppose you want to hear about Cazador. I don't want to say a damned thing, but that won't do anyone any good. Cazador Zar is a vampire lord in Baldur's Gate, the patriarch of his coven, and a monster obsessed with power. Not political power or military power, I mean power over people. The power to control them completely. He turned me nearly 200 years ago. I became his spawn, and he became my tormentor. Not him, no. A gang of thugs attacked me, angry about a ruling that I'd handed down as magistrate. They beat me to death's door when Cazador appeared. He chased them off and offered to save me, to give me eternal life. Given that my choices were eternal life or bleed to death on the street, I took him up on the offer. It was only afterwards I realized just how long eternity could be. He had me go out into Baldur's Gate to fetch him the most beautiful souls I could find. It was a fun little ritual of his. I'd bring them back, and he'd ask if I wanted to dine with him. And if I said yes, he'd serve me a dead, putrid rat. Of course, if I said no, he'd have me flayed. Hard to say which was worse. I will, but I won't take it for granted. The Mind Flayers aren't the only monsters out there. They're not even the only ones hunting us. All I'm asking is that you keep your eyes open and watch out for anything lurking in the shadows. What more could I ask? Now, is that all?
Huh. So, that's what people mean when they talk about butterflies in their stomach. Did you want something? Very serious of you. But go ahead. Even if I could remember, I'm not sure I'd tell you. I don't want your ego to get overinflated.
What now?
Is that blood?
No, never mind.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
These things have stayed interesting.
What's next?
How many die today? How many die tomorrow?
Can't afford to stay idle.
Feels like my magic is getting trained. That might be worth a look.
Close. Easy. Thank you.
Still alive, so that's progress.
All's well that ends. Not as bad as it could have. First step is the hardest. Chest. I can feel its magic.
Let's get going.
Careful, I might.
Still alive, so that's progress.
Let's get on with it.
Have a lot on my mind. And, well, in it.
There is work to do.
All's well that ends not as bad as it could have.
What's next, I wonder?
A long road ahead.
I spy with my little eye. Nothing I know, really. Strange place for a button, especially one that doesn't work.
Is formed from slate and engraved with Githyanki writing. You examine them closely, but can't make much sense of them. Without a cipher or primer to aid you, the disc's message could be near impossible to discern. Eye, the symbols trade places with each other until a clear pattern forms. And from that pattern, a story emerges. The Prince of the Comet, Part 1. So it was that we were free from Gaik shackles and turned our blades on each other The heavens were shattered, and one great empire was divided in two. Gith traveled to the Hells to broker help for her people, her cause. Vlakith would have you believe Mother Gith proclaimed her our queen. Lies. Gith made no such proclamation. Vlakith seized the empire against the mother's wishes, but Gith had nurtured a son, Orpheus, prince of the comet, the true heir. He knew Vlakith's treachery. Orpheus rallied Gith's honor guard and declared the throne for himself. The War of the Comet had begun. It's an intriguing tale, and a forbidden one, given how expertly it was encoded.